Mark Walker now speaks to Paul Shellard from the National Education Union to get an update on the proposed academisation of Moulsecoomb Primary School.
So I'm here with Paul Shellard from the National Education Union. Welcome back to latest news, Paul. Got a good update, haven't we, for Moulsecoomb Primary School, which we've been covering in a lot of detail. This could be seen as positive news, right?
Yeah, definitely. The sponsor, the New Horizons Academy Trust, have pulled out, so they won't be the sponsor, and that's very good news for the whole community that have been campaigning against academisation of their local school.
Yeah. And is there any reason for why they pulled out? Do we know that?
Well, they haven't been absolutely clear about why they pulled out, but Lee Murley, who's the leader of the trust, did release a press statement. Unfortunately, he didn't share that with the school or the council, so they only found out about it through the press. But he announced that the trust was pulling out, and unfortunately, he also said that there was a chance of the school closing, which is a completely false claim. And the council has put out a letter to parents clarifying the position that Moulsecoomb School is not in the position of closing. And he also used the opportunity to be insulting to the staff, describing the atmosphere at the school as being toxic. He made a comment which was negative about parents, saying that the trust would not bow down to them. So it's really unfortunate that rather than making a positive comment about the school and wishing it all the best in the future, he chose to be negative and to be insulting towards the staff and the community. And I think that's very unfortunate.
And is there a reason? I mean, he's got no evidence of that, I'm guessing. So was that just sour grapes in a way? Or?
Well, I think it is sour grapes in a way. I think it's the kind of thing that if a child behaved like that, you'd probably ask them to kind of think about their behaviour. I don't know what his reasons were. Obviously, they only run one school, that particular trust, so they want to take over other schools. Otherwise, they're spending a lot on leadership and directors and administration, so they want to spread those costs. One of our main concerns was, of course, that we want more money to go on teaching and learning, and in academy schools, more tends to be paid to directors. Now, I don't know if he was disappointed because he thought that there would be more money coming his way, coming through his salary, and that this has put the kibosh on it, but that's the situation.
So we've got a Conservative government in place now, so that means that probably Ofsted's there to stay, and it's all about trying to persuade the Secretary of State now, if I've got it correct, in them trying to reverse the Academy order, right?
Is that where we're at? I mean, essentially, the change of government should make no difference to that process. We have argued that the school has made a great deal of progress, and that's been shown in SATS results and lots of other things. And the council, which has put in additional support, is also very clear that it's on a trajectory of improvement. So we are calling for Ofsted to come back and to re-inspect the school.
Yeah.
We're confident that the school would not be regarded as inadequate. We don't think it was inadequate before. We certainly don't think it is now. And that should mean that the Secretary of State could revoke that Academy order and basically accept the wishes of the local community who, you know, parents and carers voted by 96% that they wanted their school to remain as part of the local authority.
Yeah, this came up in the election hustings, and I was there for the one for Brighton Kemp Town, and for one of the hustings anyway, and I know there's cross-party support for it, the school to be re-inspected, including from the Conservative. So what are your next steps then? I'm guessing you're going to have to engage with the new Conservative administration. There could be a new Secretary of State for Education in February. It doesn't look like they're going to change it before February next year. So it's going to be Gavin Williamson. So have you got a plan in place?
Well, I think you're right, first of all, that locally there has been unity on this issue. So the council, both Labour and other parties, including the Tories, have been supportive of the school remaining with the local authority. I mean, even the candidate for Kemp Town, who took part in a hustings and first of all said that he thought the academies programme was a good idea and that Moulsecoomb should be academised, later visited the school and said he understood what why the campaign was so strong and accepted that the school works very hard to serve that local community. Now, clearly, for the campaign to be effective, we do need to have support across the political spectrum, and we have sought that up to this point, and we will continue doing that, whether that means speaking to Conservative councillors as well, and certainly speaking to the current Education Minister and whoever takes over as the next Education Minister. That's going to be very important as well. Yes, yeah. this isn't something where we're saying only people of a certain political persuasion are going to support this campaign. This is a community campaign,
yes.
And it has support right across the political spectrum.